Afternoon. Well, I've been here for about 4 or 5 hours actually. I've actually been waiting to get into this swim. This is a swim that I was in last week, where I had a good few fish.
Well, here we are.
I've got a couple of baits out in the usual spots for this swim, which of course is one on the plateau, one at the base of the plateau, and the right hand rod is just out there in the weed line. But I'm going to move that right hand rod round. Possibly it might move it over to the left here and put it further around on the plateau. I might put it on nearer the base as well, so I've got two rods on the base. I don't know. We'll have to see how things go. I don't really like crowding a swim with three rods. I think two's enough. So I'll probably keep this right hand rod on the weed line out there. I may elect to put it just at the margin here where I put a load of bait the other day. And in fact, what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab a couple of handfuls of bait. My back pocket. Go up to the next swim, which fortunately for me is out of action. That makes it nicer. It means I've got virtually this entire bank corner to myself. And in fact, we've had, I think there was 8 anglers on last night and 5 the night before. They're virtually all gone. We had Simon Crow down here doing his open access waters article for the last 2 days as well. He had a few. Simon was on the other side of the lake. He's gone. And his mate that was with him has gone as well. The two lads that were here have gone. There's only 2 lads over there. And I think they might be going soon. So I could be on my own again. Now, right down here, there's a big yellow spot. Big yellow patch. So what I elected to do was put a load of bait down there on that spot. Of course, this is feeding the ducks and the coots as well to a certain degree, but wow. They're all going on that spot, lovely. That's where the spot is, just there. Well, that last handful fell. Let's get these on that spot there. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to nip up here every now and again with Polaroids and just keep an eye out and see if there's any fish feeding on that bait. So there you go. There's a handy little sign. I should make a few of those up actually and put them on the bank here. I think I'd get in trouble with Mike the owner actually. So, we're all sorted. Everything's pucker. I've been round and had a chat with everybody, so yeah. Time to put the kettle on, I think. It's a nice southwesterly coming in though, isn't it?
Well, it's just like a summer's day here.
The sunshine is out in full.
Strange thing is, the wind is coming from the northwest when it's actually supposed to be coming from the southwest. I really should stop using the Met Office weather forecast, shouldn't I? It's bloody crap. Sorry. It seems. I'm not going to move my bivvy for the fourth time unless I'm absolutely sure, and then I shall move it to that position because I don't particularly want the wind blowing in. There's some fish on the top. I've tried a floater and I've put some floating baits out there, but of course the ducks are just clearing them away, which is what they're doing now.
Vlog time. We haven't been here that long. Actually, I went off to use the lavatory for a little while, so I took the rods out. I got back, I put the left hand rod out on the plateau and left it. Then I put the right hand rod out on the base of the plateau. And as I was putting the right hand rod out, left hand rod went. And I got this absolute stonker. I've got a real treat for you. I really have. I'm going to try and get a picture. First of all, I'm going to lift the fish up to see how lively it is. Great scrap, but it's to be expected from a common. I love commons, especially when they look like this. He's a lively little beast, I'll tell you that. Look at this one. Fins up. 21 pounds of hard fighting, wonderful common.
Look at it. It's just incredible, isn't it? Let's see if we can get a fish with a little baby. Okay. That's it, you keep your fins up like that. Fins up. Fins down. Let's check the picture quickly. Right, let's have a look at you. Oh yeah, pucker picture. No need to take any more. Now let's show it to the camera again. I mean, it's an absolute beauty. I mean, if you caught this from the wall pack, you know, you would be well chuffed. It's in stunning condition. There really isn't any problems with this fish whatsoever. It's absolutely lovely, isn't it? Let's get a little bit closer. There you go. Absolutely gorgeous. I'm well pleased with this fish. Put up a terrific scrap. And they're obviously still on that area, aren't they? They're still going in there. So I better get that rod back out and some more bait, I think. Let's put this baby back. What a stonker. Look at it. Look at it. Absolutely. Fantastic fishing. Well, there you go. Let's see if we can get him on his other side. To go, doesn't he? Really does, there he goes. Excellent stuff. Come on, what a result. It's okay. I've just left this for about 5 minutes. Do you know what? I can't actually see because I've got my sunglasses on. I've just left this for about 5 minutes, there you go, I've completely missed it. There you go, it's invisible, this fluorocarbon X line. Just left that for about 5 minutes for that point to settle on the bottom. I'm not using backlets at the moment. There you go, perfect balance. I've got my line really, really slack. It's just going straight down here, it's right on the bottom. So that fish came off the plateau out there. What I've done is I've moved the left hand rod, which was the plateau rod, and the right and the middle rod, which was the base of the plateau, now to the right and to the left. Sorry, to the right and to the middle. Get confused here. So the left hand rod, which was out there, which was the right, is now the left. I've put it off area, just over there. Same length, but just off area with a bag. Yeah, I think that might get me a fish. Well, as you can see, the lake looks pretty good, doesn't it, with this wind. It's coming from the northwest. Supposed to be coming from the southwest. So I moved my bivvy for the fourth time from there to there. And I've got a nice big porch area here for my winter skin, so I should be all right and out the draft. Well, I am an old man, eh? I'm at a bit of a dilemma, actually. I'm not quite sure how much bait, really, I got out earlier because of the seagulls. I guess, really, probably 3-4 handfuls have gone in since I've been here, and I'm thinking maybe I should top the swim up. But then I'm thinking maybe if I top the swim up, it might spook the fish. I don't know. So I'm thinking I'll probably put a couple of handfuls in before dark anyway, for sure. And then sleep on it.